Thank you. So I'm Ken Chapwurst. I guess the conductor who usually comes out at this point. Most of the conducting tonight will be done by our guest, Jim McNeely. Very happy to have him here with us. Jim played with Thad Jones in the Thad Jones Mel Lewis Jazz Orchestra, which then became the Mel Lewis Jazz Orchestra, which is now the Vanguard. And he knows that history, I think, about as well as anyone in the world at this point. So really an honor to have him. Why don't you join me in welcoming to the stage Jim McNeely.
Thank you. Thank you. Is this working? I can't tell. I was told it was going to be on all the time. Well, there we go. Thank you. Now it's on. Thank you. Welcome to our concert. We're here to celebrate the 100th anniversary of the birth of the great Thad Jones. It was actually last month, the exact date. But Thad Jones, of course, originally from Pontiac, Michigan, and along with his brothers Hank and Elvin, really had a great, huge impact on the jazz scene in the 50s, 60s, 70s, 80s, and until they all passed away. Piece that we opened with was something that he wrote when he was with the Count Basie band. Most of the music we're going to be playing tonight dates from the Thad Jones, Mel Lewis period. I think that's the period that most people are familiar with. But I wanted to make sure to include something from before Thad and Mel and also from after Thad and Mel. So we opened with Counterblocking. It's a thing he recorded with the Basie band. That featured, wow, I don't have any names. Anyone who soloed on that tune, stand up and take a bow. Wunderbar. Okay, great, thank you. Now we're going to do, since we are at the New England Conservatory, I thought maybe there's a smidgen of technical talk involved here. That tune we just played, Counterblocking, is based on the chord changes of I've Got Rhythm in F. And through his career, Thad wrote a number of pieces based on the chord changes of I've Got Rhythm. We're going to play another one now from the days with Thad and Mel. He actually wrote this originally for the Basie band at the end of his time with the band, and Basie thought it was, he wrote several arrangements that Basie thought just weren't right for the band, and you know, you ought to go form your own band, which he ended up doing, and the rest is history. So this is another song based on the chords of I've Got Rhythm. It's up a minor third, so we're up in A flat now, if you're keeping track at home on these kinds of things. And this is called The Little Pixie. And if you listen carefully, there's a few similarities. You can hear how what he was doing when he wrote Counterblocking kind of stewed around in his mind for a few years and then came out again as Little Pixie. So this is The Little Pixie. Thank you. Thank you, the little Pixie. That's one of my all-time favorite endings of any of Thad's pieces and intros as well. That was the saxophone section. Woo! Soloing on that. And also on the drums. Yeah. Thank you. We're now going to do a slower piece. We started with something he wrote for Count Basie when he was with Count Basie, and then we played something he wrote at the end of his time with Count Basie as he was forming Thad Jones' Mel Lewis Jazz Orchestra. This is a piece that he actually wrote for Thad and Mel, and it's called Kids Are Pretty People. And when I started playing with Thad Jones, Mel Lewis, I found out there's a subtitle to this, which is Kids Are Pretty People When They Don't Belong to You. So that was Thad's little addition. So Kids Are Pretty People. Thank you. Kids are pretty people. On the solo, yeah. Thank you. As I said, we're focusing mostly on music from the Thad Jones, Mel Lewis Jazz Orchestra period, but I also wanted to do something from after Thad and Mel. Thad left the band in early 1980. He had the opportunity to become the chief conductor of the Danish radio big band over in Copenhagen. And it was kind of a nasty kind of time with Thad and Mel. I was in the band at that time. And Thad left, never really told Mel he was leaving. He was kind of like, you know, the proverbial guy that goes out for a newspaper one night and never comes back and leaves the wife and kids. And so the parting of ways was not quite so amicable, at least for a while. So Thad went to Copenhagen, and Mel continued the band under the name of Mel Lewis and the Jazz Orchestra, and he brought in Bob Brookmeyer to be the musical director of his own band. But Thad, of course, continued to write music when he was over in Denmark, and we're going to play one of those pieces now. Besides conducting the Danish radio big band, he also had his own band called Eclipse over there, which included a number of American expats who were living in and around Copenhagen at the time. And this is something that he wrote, and no one that he was working with recorded it at the time. It was finally recorded sometime later by a Swedish band called the Monday Night Orchestra. And this is called Return Journey, and it's an interesting piece because at one point, you know, Thad started out writing for the Basie band, which is basic brass and saxophones, but he got more into the tonal palettes available to him from the saxophone players in Thad and Mel, who were great studio musicians and also doubled on things like flute and clarinet. So he studied orchestration and really got into writing for woodwinds, and this piece reflects that. And also a little known fact for those of you who are jazz piano history buffs out there, Herbie Hancock's famous recording, Speak Like a Child, which Thad played on. Thad also really kind of arranged a lot of the music on that record for bass, trombone, and flugelhorn, and alto flute. So he got much more interested in writing for woodwinds, and this piece reflects that. So this is Return Journey. Thank you. Return Journey. That's Jonathan. I do know the piano player's name. Jonathan on the piano. Right now we're going to do probably the best known composition of Thad Jones. And this is a wonderful lyrical waltz that he wrote called A Child Is Born. Thank you.
Jim McNeely on piano.
All right, thank you. A child is born. We're going to close the first half of the concert with, this is another I've Got, wow, we've got six tunes the first half. Three of them are based on I've Got Rhythm. This is in the key of B flat, so we've had F, A flat, and B flat, and the tempo's gotten faster, so I guess there's some rhyme or reason to that. This is another pretty well-known composition of his. And it's going to feature the saxophone section and some other solos. And this is called Fingers. Ha ha ha.
Thank you.
fingers, the saxophone section, trombone, Jonathan, drums, everybody. Great, thank you. Manuel, the band. Thank you. We're going to get a sip of water and wipe the blood off the floor back in the trumpet section, and we'll be back in a few minutes. Thank you. Welcome to the second half. So far, we've been doing all music composed by Thad Jones. This time, we're going to start off the second half with a piece composed by me. But there's a reason for that. When in about 1990-something, 5, 95, I had left the Vanguard Jazz Orchestra. Mel Lewis passed away in 1990, and the band became the Vanguard Jazz Orchestra. And I had left as the piano player. And in 1994, they asked me to write an album's worth of music for them, a new album for the Vanguard Jazz Orchestra. And I readily accepted. And the first two things I wrote, I thought, there's a couple of things I've got to get off my chest. So I wrote a tribute piece to Mel Lewis. And then I wrote what we're going to play here, a piece as a tribute to Thad Jones. And the more familiar you are with Thad's music, the more inside baseball you're going to get. It's chock full of quotes from Thad's things, some of them placed in really backwards kind of formations and so forth. As I said, it's my dedication to Thad, all that he means to me. And we did a lot of focus groups and market research on what to call this piece. And finally, we decided Thad. So here it is. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thad with Jonathan on piano and the other folks here, trombone, trumpet. Great, thank you. Thank you. This next arrangement, it's one of Thad's tunes, but it's arranged by myself. Kind of an interesting thing about Thad's career is before he joined the Basie band, he was a rising young trumpet star, small group player, and composer. He wrote some really interesting tunes, and his first album that he ever did as a small group leader was called The Fabulous Thad Jones. And we're going to play one of the tunes from that record now. It's called Elusive. And I arranged this for the Frankfurt Radio Big Band a few years ago. Again, for those of you keeping track of such things, the form of this tune is pretty elusive. It's a blues, a four-bar bridge, another blues in another key, a 16-bar thing, and then the first chorus of blues again. So it's a pretty complicated story that he weaves with this song. So this is Elusive. Thank you. Elusive, yes. Thank you. We're not going to go back to a blues that Thad wrote. He was a fan of playing the horses, and so this is something he wrote back in the early days of Thad and Mel. This is called The Second Race. Thank you. The second raise, blues. The saxophone, Ryan and... Sam. Okay, thank you. Great. We're now going to do a ballad that Thad wrote for a combined record session that featured both the Count Basie Orchestra and the Duke Ellington Orchestra. And this is also, for me as a veteran of the band, and this is also the last piece of music that Mel Lewis ever played in his life, so has a special meaning for me and other people in the Vanguard Orchestra. And this is called To You.
Thank you.
To you, Thad Jones. Thank you. And on the trombone, yes. We have one more. Before we do that, I'd like to thank all of you for coming tonight. Hey, give yourself an applause. I'd also like to thank everyone on stage here for all the work they put into this music. It's been fun. Thank you. And of course, a special thanks to Ken Schaphorst for inviting me to be in this concert and for all that he does for the program here at New England Conservatory. I've been here a number of times. I'm always impressed with the musicianship and the way everybody plays and comes together for the concert. So it's been really, really gratifying to be here this time. And also thanks to Thad Jones for being an inspiration to me for so many years and an inspiration for so many musicians in the world of jazz. So we're going to finish now with just an old shuffle that he wrote, and this is called Don't Get Sassy. Don't Get Sassy, the saxophone section, the saxophone solos, trumpet solos, piano solo, and the band. Think about it. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. The band, take a bow. Yeah. All right. Thank you. Good night.